us today. That we will just put away anything that is bothering us. Any fear, anxiety, anger, depression, unforgiveness. We are putting it aside. We are giving it up so that we can have you. So that we can have you in your presence today. That we may have ears to hear what you have to say to us. That we will accept it, obey it, and walk in it. We just thank you. We just give you glory today. All the glory and all the honor belongs to you today. It is in your name that we pray and we say, amen. Let's worship the Lord today.
God, my Savior, the one trust you this morning. We thank you that you made the way through Jesus Christ, that you didn't give up on us. And you sent the best you had. You sent your one and only Son to pay a price that we couldn't pay. We didn't qualify. And Jesus didn't deserve to, but he was the only one that did. So we thank you, Lord Jesus. We praise you this morning. Yes. We honor you. We reverence you. We welcome you here.
Yes.
Father, you have your way here this morning. We yield ourselves over to the Spirit of God. Say, Holy Spirit, you have your way.
Yes, Holy Spirit, have.
We'll have hearts to receive what you have to say today. We'll have hearing ears. Ears of our heart to purpose to know and to understand what the will of the Lord is for each and every one of us here today. So we bless you. We honor you. We give you thanks and praise. And we thank you in advance for all that you will do here this morning, and all that you will say.
Yes.
It's in Jesus' name we pray. If you can agree with that, shout a big amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You may be seated for just a few minutes. If you want to sit down for a couple minutes,
yeah,
probably 10 minutes.
Okay.
Give you a break from up there. Worship team's going to help today, and the kids are going to help today. Because God knows I need help. All right. Let's continue to worship through our giving. Amen. We got one amen. A few like, where are we going? You know, we give because we're responding to God. We're responding to what he has written in his word, what he has already declared, what he's decreed, what he set up for ordinances for us. How many know God knows better than we do? He's got things figured out better than we do. And the sooner we figure that out and let him be first in our life in all things, then things will get better. We tend to try to figure out things 22 ways and then finally drop to our knees and go to God and say, God, I just can't figure it out. And he's saying, I've been waiting for you. I've been waiting for you to show up. He wants a part of every part of you. And so when we bring the tithe is a heart issue. Giving into what is important to him is a heart issue. Do you trust him? We sing it. Don't you like that song? I trust in God. You know, in Psalm 34, that's where those words come from. I sought the Lord and he heard me and he answered. Do you know he'll never not answer when you come before him in faith? It's impossible for him to not answer. Say that. It's impossible for God not to answer me when I come in faith. Now, that's the qualifier right there. I'm going to read from Proverbs just because I'm up here, got the microphone, and I got my Bible open to Proverbs. We're going to have fun today. Is that okay? This is not a dead church. It never will be. You can just relax. It's a safe place. You can let your guard down. God is here. God is here. We may sing that one. Did you guys not want to take a sit down? That's okay if you want. Well, I've got about 10 minutes of talking before I get you back on. Seven? I said seven? You can stand if you want. Maybe I should have everybody else stand too. You know, it's scriptural. Jesus said that he began to teach. He says he sat down. It's found in Isaiah 61. He sat down and began to teach them. So it's not scriptural that you all sit and I have to stand. But that's the way we do it. And I think it's because nobody would come if that's the place they make you stand all service. So being somewhat smart, I invested in good seats that will keep your tushy nice and comfortable for at least 4 hours. So if you put the pot roast on, you better call the fire department now. That's why they invented crock pots. So you don't have to rush out of church. It was a preacher that invented the crock pot. Did you know that? Did you hear the story of the elderly man here that he's driving downtown and he rear-ended somebody? Did anybody hear that? He rear-ended some yuppie in a BMW, I guess. And the guy gets out of the BMW. This is an old guy. He's like in his 90s. And the guy starts screaming at him, the old man, and he says, I'm going to beat you into a pulp if you don't give me $10,000 to fix my bumper, $10,000 bumper, I guess. And he said, I don't have that kind of money. He said, let me call my son. He trains dolphins. He'll know what to do. The guy's like, this is a crackpot. So the old man gets on his phone and he calls his son and he says, Dad, he says, I've rear-ended somebody. He says he's going to pulverize me if I don't give him $10,000. He says, tell him I'll be there in 10 minutes. And so the guy, before he hung up, he grabbed the phone from him, and he said, are you the dolphin trainer? He said, I'm going to beat you up, too. And so the guy shows up. This Jeep pulls up. This guy gets out, and he rips this guy up and puts him in a heap on the side of the road. And then he walks over to his son, his dad, and he says, Dad, he says, I train SEALs, Navy SEALs, not dolphins. I thought of you, Bill, when I heard that. My son, do not forget my law. I told you we're going to have fun today. But how many kids have we got here? Look at all the kids. My son, do not forget my law, but let your heart keep my commands. That means to obey him, to do it, right? For length of days and long life and peace they will add to you. So our obedience can prolong our days on the earth. God hasn't picked a day for you to die. A lot of people believe that. That's not what this says. He said, you obey me, and you can have long life. Look at this, though. He says, and peace. You can have peace with your long life. How many need peace in your life? That's all? Man, I thought everybody put your hands up. I'll put both mine up for you. Nobody's got a gun. You know, in this church, there's nobody pointing a gun at us when we put our hands up. We're just worshiping God. It's an act of surrender. You know, I surrender what's going on in my life, and I'm just coming before you to worship you. Amen? That's good preaching right there. Let not mercy and truth forsake you or abandon you. Bind them around your neck and write them on the tablet of your heart. And then you can find favor and high esteem or high value, high respect in the sight of God. And man, who said that? Thank you. You know your Bible. That's your verse? You want to come up and say it? No? Okay. Okay. That's wonderful. When the kids are here, you never know what will happen. So that's why I trust in God. Because we're broadcasting now. The red light is on. I could never figure out why when the red light's on, we're on. Anybody ever figure that out? You know, years ago when you had a tape recorder and you push the button and it starts recording and the button's red. Doesn't red mean stop? Mr. Engineer in the back, what's the reason? He doesn't know. He just designs and keeps TV stations running. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. If we can just get to that part where we can do that daily. Wake up every day and say, today, Lord, I'm going to trust you. I don't know what the day brings me, but whatever it brings me, I'm going to trust you. I know you'll get through it. Get me through it. He says, lean not onto your own understanding. Do you know God doesn't bless our plans? Well, a couple of you knew that. Well, let me just share that. God doesn't, he's not obligated, or does he bless our plan? He wants us to get hooked up with his plan, which already has the blessing on it. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. It will be health to your flesh. Health to your flesh. That's a healing scripture right there. Boy, didn't we have some wonderful meetings here in the last 3 days, 4 days. I'm telling you, God is setting this church up for victory. With the people that are connecting with us, I'm just amazed. And it's getting gooder and gooder. That lady's not here that's the English teacher, right? I had an older woman give her heart to the Lord, and she came up front, and as I'm talking with her, I said to her, I says, it's just getting gooder and gooder, isn't it? And she corrected me. She said, that's not good English. I said, well, you didn't get my dictionary then. I says, it's in my dictionary. It's okay. Oh, my. I think I got detention from her that day. Anyway, it will be health to your flesh and strength to your bones. Doesn't that get you excited? Some of you that are older than 15? It'll be strength to your bones. Come on. We saw some bones get fixed this week. We saw some people that were hobbling at first, and pretty soon they're going up and down stairs and running down the aisle. Come on. You can't make this up. And we've got it recorded, so if you miss these meetings, there weren't this many people. There was almost, but not quite. We'll have them on YouTube. Now, I never thought I'd ever have a YouTube station, but I do. I'm just amazed. I don't know how to work it. I don't know how to get on it, but they tell me I have one. Honor the Lord. Here's where we're getting to. Honor the Lord with your possessions. The Amplified says, with your capital and sufficiency. So honor him. What does that mean? He says, well, here, mortal men receive tithes, but there, Jesus in heaven receives them. So you're worshiping the Lord when we bring our tithes and offerings to him. He says, delight yourself in the Lord, not here, but in Psalm 37, 5, I think it is, delight yourself in the Lord, he'll give you the desires of your heart. So if you want the desires of your heart to come true, then delight yourself in what God's doing. Delight yourself in what he's interested in. Have you ever gone before the Lord instead of, you know, we used to years ago, we'd go with a list. I'd been to prayer meetings all my life, and you go with a list of things we got to ask him for. That's really not the way to approach God. Because 2 Peter, see, once I found out that he's already given me everything that pertains to life and godliness, then I don't have to go with him to him with a list and say, God, I need this. He's already got that. Well, God, I need this. Well, he's already got that. And you say, what are you talking about, preacher? He's put it inside of our heart. When you got born again, everything you need is inside of you. And when you hear his word, when you apply his word, get his word into the good ground of your heart, it's going to produce. Just like we've been talking about the agricultural seed going into the ground. The ground brings forth the miracle. Man doesn't know how that works, nor will they ever. And Jesus said, just like the kingdom of God is, now the seed is God's word. When you plant it in your heart starts to produce the life that you need. It begins to produce healing. It begins to produce kindness. If you meditate on kindness scriptures, you'll find yourself being more kind. You know, the world needs to see that in Christians. The world needs to see that we really care. Last evening, I didn't study the word last night for today. I watched Jesus Revolution. How many of y'all seen that? I went to the big screen and saw that. If you haven't seen it, you need to see it. Greg Laurie. Yeah. What a cool movie. Jesus Revolution. And you know, that church reminded me of some churches I've been to. Where you get the stiff necks sitting over here, and when the hippies came in, they got mad. Some of them got up and left. You know, I know some people probably don't like my red sneakers, but in that show, they all came in with no shoes on at all. And they told him, said, these people aren't even wearing shoes. They're dirtying up our carpet. So then the next Sunday, the pastor's sitting out at the front steps, washing everybody's feet that came in. I tell you what, the religious devils didn't like that. And they came in. I tell you what, some of those hippies knew how to play the guitar. And they brought worship like never before. They had church. Glory to God. Glory to God. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Honor the Lord with your possessions and with the first fruit. Stand with me. Of all your increase. You know all your increase comes from God? All your increase, every bit of it. The air, the cubic feet of air that we've breathed today, God created that. Just think if he decided to take it all away. No, God has given us everything. Hold up your offerings to heaven. Let's worship him. So the tithe is 10% of your increase, but the tithe and tithing are not the same thing. Tithing is when you believe it and you worship him with it. That's what tithing is. And then tithing is what you say. And so say this with me. Father God, I come before you this morning to worship you with an increase and offerings of all that you've given me. I honor you. I bless you. I worship you. In Jesus' name, amen. Ushers, you may receive it. Doreen, did you ever find that video that I... You did? Maybe we could play that now because everybody's a little bit too quiet right now. And so I think that would help us. So you're going to have to... We'll have to put the screen down. We're going... Oh, then I'm going to have the kids come up, and we're going to teach a little bit, and then we're going to get them into, that's as far as I know. Okay. All right. Projector will have to go on. I forgot to tell you that. And the screen will have to come down. And then everybody needs to be extremely quiet for this song, for this video. I don't want to peep. Not a peep. Be reverent. We're in church. Are you having fun yet?
Yeah.
Oh, shh, shh. Well, I didn't say it for me. I can be loud. Oh, I thought she found it. You can quick. You can go to YouTube and do it. You can do that. I take authority over this thing in Jesus' name. You work. You work in Jesus' name. Well, we can go on to something else while you're finding it. All right. Lights back on. Okay. So a couple things going on this week. This is Sanctity of Life week, I believe. And Annie wanted to give a speech, I think. Where's Annie? No, I guess she didn't. She left. That's why she knew I would do that. Anyway, you should have... Where's mine? Oh, it's in here. I've got it. So we'll get these things out of the way, and then not that we want to get them out of the way, but... while they're trying to find my video to keep you quiet. So you should have gotten a flyer that was included with your bulletin that says, love them both. And a professor in college ethics class presented his students with a problem. He said a man has syphilis and his wife has tuberculosis. They've had four children. One has died. The other three have what is considered to be a terminal illness. The mother is pregnant. What do you recommend? And so after a spirited discussion, the majority of the class voted that she should abort the child. Fine, said the professor. You've just killed Beethoven. People don't realize that God has created. It takes a man and a woman, but God is the one that forms. God is the one that puts life into this baby that's going to have a future and a destiny designed by him. Our destiny is not designed or set forth by our parents. It's set forth by God. And so under no circumstances, I just read an excerpt from a doctor who's been a doctor for 50 years. And he said he has never seen or heard of any doctors reporting that they aborted a child to save the mother's life. But yet we hear that all the time. Well, what about in this? Because if they can get you to believe it's okay to do this, then they just keep extending it, right? Yeah. 6 weeks, 9 weeks, 20 weeks. Hey, how about just after they're 10 weeks old? That's what they'd ultimately like it to be. Yeah. I mean, there's people on the planet that want to get rid of 7 billion of us. So anyway, I was at a prayer meeting before this ministry ever became a ministry. And I came out of that prayer meeting, and the Lord spoke to me and said, go down to that place on Union Avenue. At the time, it wasn't Aspire. It was the Lakes Region Pregnancy Crisis Center. And he said, I want you to get involved with that financially. And so I began to do that all those years ago. They're a ministry. Read what they... If you don't know much about Aspire, you need to, because they are right alongside us preaching the gospel. They're preaching the gospel to young men and women that find themselves in a hurtful place. And so we can't give up on these people. We need to love them. The easiest thing is to just get the problem out of the way, but that's not the right thing. And so... we support, this ministry, Faith Alive, supports Aspire every single month. And I don't know how many people in heaven will approach me and say thank you. And that doesn't matter if they, you know, do, but I believe that when we get to heaven, the things we put our money into, God keeps record. And I believe people's eyes will be opened to know. Just like Bill Foster Jr. here, he spent 5 years in the Amazon. He didn't get to meet all these people. He trained up pastors that are going to give altar calls, that are going to bring people and then disciple them. And when he gets to heaven, I believe that he's going to have a lot of years where they keep coming up to him from the Ooga Booga swamps. Because he said yes to Jesus. He said yes to the Lord's call on his life. Anyway, secondly, Tuesday is voting day. I'm holding what is called the Documents of Freedom. It's got our Constitution, it's got the Declaration of Independence, and it also has George Washington's farewell address. If anybody would like one of these, I will get one for you. I buy them and hand them out to people. Everybody needs to know what your rights are in this country. Too many people don't, and so that's why so many people don't vote. They don't understand. You can't go to most countries on the planet and vote. You just do what they tell you. God set this country up. And he's given us rights. And he said, you know, the preamble, we hold these truths to be self-evident, that we're all created equal, and we're endowed by our Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among them are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. You've got to be willing to stand up and voice your vote for righteousness. It's not about Republican. It's not about Democrat. You let God show you. But I'll say this, and I'll get in trouble, but I don't care. If you're a Democrat, you need to pull up the copy of the platform that they say they believe, because they want to kill babies. and they declare it in their document. If you sign on to that, if you vote for that, then it's going to be on your shoulders too. I know that doesn't really go over popular, but we need to vote righteousness. And I'll tell you what, Republicans aren't perfect. Nobody was but Jesus. But you got to let God show you. You got to let God show you. Okay. One last announcement. Yes. Chicken, broccoli, Alfredo. That ought to get everybody back to church. Whether you like my preaching or not, come for the food. I'm coming. $10. And it's to support our teens to go to camp. Camp with John Tash. Okay, yours couldn't have been the last announcement because there's one more last announcement. Thank you, David. Thank you. Next Saturday morning. Okay? Okay. Were we able to? We're overcomers. Yes, we are. Shh. This is where you're supposed to be quiet. I don't want to see you move, Carol. Because you're usually... We have the lights on the stage taken down, too, please. Oh, no. I don't know if that's the right one.
Let me hear the worshipers! Where's all of my praises? I want everybody around the world to put your hands together because all the praise belongs to God. Here we go.
Every word of worship,
with one accord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. All right, if we could have the kids come up front. Today's Kids Sunday. I'm definitely going to need some help. While they're coming, just a plug for our adult class. On Sunday mornings, we start at 9 o'clock, go till about 9:45. We're going to be looking at and studying Andrew Womack's book, You've Already Got It. How many have never seen or heard of this book? All right, well, you need to get a copy of it. In this little book right here, it shows you everything that belongs to you in Christ. You've already got it. People are looking, they're even with healing, and we had wonderful meetings here in the last 3 days, people are looking for God to do something for them, not realizing he already has. Jesus went to the cross. He paid for your sin. He went to that whipping post. He paid for your sickness and disease. The chastisement necessary, needful for us to have peace in life was upon him. He bore our sicknesses. He carried away our pains. If he carried it, why do you want to carry it? You don't, but you keep going around the what you've not understood and thinking, God, if you can just pray and get him to move. God's not moving. He's seated right now. He's not running around up there. Jesus is seated beside him, and so are you and me. That might be new revelation to some of you here today. The Bible says we were raised up with him and seated in heavenly places. We're seated right there. We have a position of authority. But you've already got everything. What you need to do is discover what God has shown us in his word. See, he wrote it down for us. We don't have to wonder. When people say, well, you never know what God will do. I know what he'll do. I know exactly what he'll do. He'll do exactly what he said he would do. So the one that says that doesn't know what he's already said. And so, are the kids up here yet? Okay. And so, this is probably in my top 10 books that are important for a believer to understand. We'll get quiet. And so if you don't have this, so we've got a dozen or so for the class. How many would be interested in going to the class? And it's not a hard class. Nobody gets picked on. No, I don't have a ruler to hit you. You know? I let Carol in. So that ought to be fun, right? She's fun. I didn't mean that in a... Look at that smile. I mean, come on. Jesus is all over her. Is it a good class? It's a great class. But what you'll come out knowing, if you apply it to your life, will change your life. How many want their lives changed? How many want 2024 to be better than 2023? I do. I'm believing for bigger and for better. And you say, why? Because Jesus paid for it. So you don't have to wander around like you do in Walmart trying to fill a basket of stuff to get. God's already given you everything you need. But it is in the spirit realm, and you need to. You see, God is a spirit. He is spirit. So we don't go to him with a grocery list. We go to him by our spirit. And so today, we're going to teach and talk about praise, and we just did some. And we're going to get the worship team back up here and do some more praise, and it's going to be fun. Say it's going to be fun. It's fun. Okay. All right. So I need one of you to help me. Paris, would you go grab those balloons for me? You want one. Okay. Well, you want one. Well, how many do we have? 2, 4, 6, 8 of you. I have 6 balloons, so a couple of you are going to have to share. Do we have any sisters? Are you guys sisters?
No.
Are you sisters with her? You're cousins. That's close. Friends and cousins. Okay. All right. So could you untie the balloons from there? And actually, the balloons are going to preach today, so... All right, I'll hold them and you. So why is it important that we praise God?
Yes.
He saved us, and so we want to praise him because of that. Yep, that's perfect. And he sacrificed his own son? That's a huge deal. And the world needs to know that, don't they? Yeah, that's good. Why else do we praise him? Because we love him. Because we love him. So because of what he's done for us, because we love him, because he first loved us. Yeah. So that's important. So we're going to look at praise. So if you could hold those for me. So I need one of you. Who would like to be the praise balloon? Right there? Okay, we'll let you have the next one. So what scripture is on there? And if we could get the, can we get the scripture verses up there? I know I'm asking a lot, but I've messed you up a couple times. All right, so the first verse is going to be Psalm 100. Everybody open your Bibles to Psalm 100. How many know some people call it a Bible? Yeah, we were just talking about John Tash, and he just can't get it. He calls it a Bible. Yeah, I think he's kind of funny, too. All right, Psalm 100. Oh, that's a good one, but that's not it. Psalm 100 says, it says, make a joyful shout to the Lord, all you lands. So it's okay to shout to the Lord, isn't it? Okay? Serve the Lord with gladness. Okay, so he's talking about your heart, right? How many of you obey mom and dad? First time, every time. At least by the third time. No, we want to, but the first time. He says, know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who has made us and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, okay, and into his courts with praise. So we've already done some of that this morning, haven't we? Right? And we're going to continue to do that, and you're going to help me. Are you all good singers today? No, yes, yes. No, yes, yes. You can sing choruses, okay? So you're going to help me, and you're going to help sing to the adults, okay? You might even teach them a few things. How about that? All right. So enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful to him, okay, and bless his name. God likes it when we worship him, when we bless his name, when we thank him. Say, thank you, Lord. What are some of the things you thank God for? Yes? Can we get the handheld mic up here? Because people are watching online and they won't know what they're saying. Say that again. Because he sacrificed his son? That's absolutely right. That's right. So it says, be thankful to him and bless his name, for the Lord is good. How many know God's good? God is a good God. He's the best. Thank you so much, Steve. Are we on? Got a blue light? Testing. I flunked the test. Testing. Hello. It's working? Test. A little. Are we on the right channel? Channel 2? Can you hear through here? No. Well, you're hearing my microphone. You've got that one. Let's see what we got next. We have the rejoice balloon. Rejoice. Okay, so you two down here, maybe your cousin?
Yes.
All right, you qualify as sister. So that is rejoice. And Philippians 4, verses 4 through 7. And Philippians 4, verse 4 says, rejoice in the Lord always. Now, some of these adults that came up during that last song, they almost rejoiced. Not quite. Rejoice means to jump up and turn around. And I saw Carol almost did. Okay? And that's okay if you do. It's not a sin in this church if you do that. Okay? Just let you know. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice. So he... Oh, no. And my page... Let your gentleness be... Why are you laughing at me? This is embarrassing. Annie, you want to come up and help me?
Yeah, right.
Let your gentleness be known to all men. The Lord is at hand. Be anxious for nothing. Are we all listening? Be anxious for nothing. How many were tempted to be anxious this week? Two of you? How many of you lied this morning? All of you that didn't put your hands up on the first one should be putting your hand up. Be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving. So prayer and supplication. Supplication is going before God with a definite request. And so it might be something about family. It might be something about your work. It could be something about do I make this decision for young people? Well, you guys are a little too young, but you guys might be thinking of school, college or something. You know, what, are you going to play basketball? You're not going to be, Paris will. It backfired all right. It says, be anxious for nothing. So this is instruction to us when we're going through stuff. How many know this? This isn't just for when you come to church. It's easy to put a smile on your face when you come to church, right? It's easy when everything's going good. But it's when things stink. I won't use that other word. It's when things are bad that we have to do this. Be anxious for nothing. He says in verse 7, what will happen? And the peace of God. You all said you needed peace of God in your life, right? Yeah. Right, kids? Yeah. Right? You especially need peace with all those sheep you got. How many years is it up to like now, 90? 23. You had more than that at one point. I won't ask what happened. I can guess, but I don't want to do it publicly. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts. We're instructed to guard our heart. You know, Adam, that was the instruction that God gave Adam, was to guard or keep the garden. He wasn't supposed to allow the devil to come in and do anything, but he did. So he slipped up. How many times have we messed up? Well, here, if we stay in the Word, it'll remind us that we need to guard our hearts and our minds. So what does this mean? Can we just watch anything that's on television? No. Can we just go to any movie just because it's at the theater? No. Why? Because we have to guard our minds and guard our hearts. You know, I've talked with Christians, you know, in the past that they think it's okay to go to horror movies. It's not. That will build an image in you and give Satan a road into your life to bring horrific things to you. You don't want those things, okay? All right, next balloon. Moving right along, because we got to get worshiping. Okay. All right, what do we got here? Victory. How many need victory in their life? Come on. Half of you don't? I don't get that one. All right, victory right here. You two are going to hold the victory. And so 1 Corinthians 15, 57. 1 Corinthians 15, 57. So on page 1926 in my Bible. But thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. The world doesn't get victory until they cross the finish line like in a sports race, but we get the victory when we enter the race. When you got born again, victory came to you. You are victorious. How many think about themselves being victorious? Well, when we're going through things, sometimes we're tempted to speak what is. Yes, dear. She won't let you hold it? Well, there's plenty of string. Just hold that part. There you go. Thanks be to God who gives us the victory. You've been given the victory. You guys are victorious. If you can learn that when you're young and you know you're victorious, that's going to help you. Because when thoughts come and maybe a friend that isn't such a good friend tells you, well, you're too short, or I don't like the color of your hair, or they might say some mean things, but you don't have to pay attention to that junk. No, because God says, I'm victorious. God sees you as the apple of his eye. In other words, God loves you so much that he's made you just the way you are. He wants you to be the way you are. So just because you got a bigger nose doesn't mean God's okay with that bigger nose. You need to be okay with it. You could probably smell better than me, so that's a good thing. You know? Okay, next balloon. We have the joy balloon. The joy balloon. You've already got. We're going to go over here. Wait a minute. Yeah, you guys, you've been holding them all this time. How about you hold the joy balloon, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, you two just won't hold them afterwards. You get to hold them now. So all of you will get one. All right, joy. Nehemiah 8:10. Does anybody know what that scripture says? The joy of the Lord is what? It's your strength. Joy is strength. How many need some joy then? If you need strength, you need more joy. Guess who gets to stir up the joy in your life? You do. You get to. You're supposed to. So when you get a bad circumstance or a bad report, just start praising the Lord. It messes with the devil's head. Like you give him a migraine when you start praising God when you're going through something. Look, just because you're going through something, it doesn't mean you're going to stay there. You're going through to the other side. You're going to have the victory. You're going to win. You're going to get the answer that you want. God said, delight yourself in the Lord. He'll give you what? The desires of your heart. Look, we got to be personal with God. Because he's designed it to be personal. That's why Christianity is unlike any other religion. It's about a relationship with Jesus Christ. It's not about rules and regulations and all the stuff that the do's and don'ts and all the craziness. I mean, there's people starving in India and there's cows wandering around the streets. That's just crazy. That's a porterhouse steak going down the road. And my kids are starving? I don't think so. I'd be going out back and butchering that thing. In love. Always in love. What are we laughing about? You guys are having fun. All right. Triumph. I'm not talking about a motorcycle. Some of you guys are like, oh, I'd like a Triumph. Triumph. Right here. Okay. And then we've got one more. And you'll get that one. Triumph, 2 Corinthians 2:14. So that's just like two pages over in my Bible. Now thanks be to God who always, say always. He always leads us in triumph in Christ. That means he always leads you into victory. You always win. So when you get up tomorrow morning, say, I'm a winner today. I'm not going to lose today. I've already been given the victory. But notice what it says here. And this is important. It says he always leads us into triumph. What does that mean we have to do? We have to follow him. What if you decide to follow your own way? Then you're not going to have victory. Come on, don't shout me down just because that's real good preaching. Thanks be to God who always leads us in triumph. All right, we're almost done. And then, Tanya, maybe you guys could start coming up. Okay. You're doubting that I said it's almost time, aren't you? She's just been here so long, she knows me. When I say we're just closing, That just means I closed that page and I'm opening another page. It's all good. Thank you, Lynn. You're my cheerleader over here. Okay, so. No, you hold right on to that one because they probably won't stay your balloons because I'm going to give you some instructions. Okay. Shout joyfully. Iris, can you shout? Can she shout? Oh, where'd they go? Yeah. She can shout? All right. Shout joyfully. Psalm 95. Hallelujah. Come on. Didn't I say we had to be quiet today in church? All right. Psalm 95. Oh, come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout joyfully to the rock of our salvation. So we're going to, you guys are going to help me sing. I'm not going to sing, but you are. He goes on to say, let us come before his presence with thanksgiving. With thanksgiving. Let us shout joyfully to him with psalms. There's a lot of good psalms which talks about us. Uh-oh. You got it. Phew. I don't want to lose two of them. That's where the other one was. It's still up there. And he goes on to say, for the Lord is a great God. Say God is a great God. He's like the best. He's like the best. So here's what we're going to do. We've got a few more worship songs to do. Oh, look at this. Oh, my goodness. Woo! Now, where's the string? All right, you want me to help you? You get it tied to your thumb. I'm surprised you didn't go up to the ceiling. Where's the balloon? Is this it? Okay. Here, why don't you tie that on? So here's what we're going to do. What do we got here? Victory? How many need victory in their life? Oh, my goodness. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. You're going to take the victory balloon, and everybody keep your hand up that needs victory in your life. When we start worshiping, I want you to go over, and I want you to sing with people and then go on to some more people. So look and see who's got their hands up for victory. This is going to get real interesting. Okay, who needs to triumph? Well, that's victory also. Okay, so then you can head over on that side, okay? So you go right now and stand beside some people, a group of people that need victory in their life, okay?
I don't really know them.
You don't have to know them.
I'm scared.
Well, introduce yourself, and then you'll know them, okay?
No?
Just walk up there, okay? Yeah. You don't have to sit. Okay. All right. Go with your sister. All right. Praise. How many know that when we come before the Lord and praise him, praise precedes the victory. Praise will precede your victory. So if you need victory here today, begin to praise him. Here's another thing praise will do. Praise will keep you in the victory. It'll keep you there. So when you're going through a situation, continue to praise him. Continue to thank him that he's already delivered you. He's already set you free. Thank him for the answer. That's what messes with the devil. That's what brings the power of God on the scene. All right, praise. You go find some people that want to praise with you. All right, Iris, what do you got? Shout joyfully. Find some radically wild people that are shouting. They have to be shouting in order for you to go. All right, go, go.
Go, go, go.
I'm dispatching joy. My How many need joy? How many need joy? Okay, take your balloon and you just walk around and praise God with some people that need some joy. Okay? So you're stirring it up. So you might even want to jump like this. Yeah. Yeah. Turn around. Yeah. Yeah. Come on.
She needs joy.
Okay. What I just demonstrated for her was rejoice. You want to rejoice? All right. Come up here with me. All right. Ready? Rejoice means to spin around. Okay? So ready? Go. Joy, rejoice, rejoice, rejoice. Yes, all right. So now you're going to get some people out here to rejoice. Okay? So we can put the lights down and we can put the music on and we're going to worship. And you kids can walk around and praise God. You can go together. Come on, come on. Yeah.
All right.
Joy, 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 victory, victory, that. Victory. Come on.
That's
why are we sitting? Come on, we're going to worship the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Glory to God. Glory to God.
Come on.
everybody. Slip up your hand if that's you. I'm going to have these kids pray with you. These kids are so... All right, we're going to start. You guys have got God's anointing inside of you. And because you have a love for people, God is going to use you to bring His healing power to people's bodies. We're going to start with the bass player over here in the corner.
Yeah.
We're going to go over and everybody's going to come with me. Be careful of the wires. Yep. If you just come around him, just put your hand on him. The Bible says that these signs shall follow them that believe. The last part of that is they'll lay hands on the sick and they'll recover. Pain must leave his body right now because we command it to go. We thank you, Lord, for your healing touch right now in our bass guitar player's body. We release that healing, that power to drive out the pain. Isn't that a good thing, kids? Isn't that great? Yeah. So we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. How are you feeling, Mr. Bass player? Much, much, much better. Much better. Okay? Did you hear that? He said he got much better. All you did was bring your supply of love, and the power of God is inside you. All right, let's go find somebody else before we close the service today. Is this okay?
Yes.
We'll start over on this side. We see some hands up back here. Put your hand up nice and high so we can find you. So we can find you. Yep. Yes, yes. He's got his hand up right now. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We minister God's healing, His anointing into Mark's body. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Strengthening him. Restoring.
Amen.
Restoring. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We praise you, Jesus. We praise you. Stir up the joy in your hearts, kids, and they do the same. It sets an atmosphere for God to be able to move. He can't do anything with doubt and unbelief, but he can do something with his attributes, which is joy, peace, love. So let's, right behind here, right here, right here.
Yeah.
Okay, both of them, both of them. All right, Father, we thank you. Just lay your hands on them. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Command pain to go. Pain must go now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. The top of their heads, the soles of their feet. Your anointing there. Your anointing. Your healing power touching them right now. Bringing restoration to them. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Over here?
Amen.
Okay. How could you not receive when you get these kids? I mean, this is precious. This is precious. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Complete healing. Complete restoration right now. And I release your peace, Father, into her mind. I release your peace. I command her emotions to just settle down under the power of God right now. Thank you. The joy of the Lord is your strength. Remember this day and remember to stir up that joy every day. Your life from this day forward will be different. In Jesus' name. Okay. Anybody else? We miss somebody? We miss somebody? Is there a hand up? Huh? Huh? Emily? I know that's Emily. Going to want to receive. How could you not want to receive? Look at these faces. Look at this. Look at this. Father, we thank you for Emily. Thank you, Lord, for your amazing love and faithfulness to Emily. She comes before you this morning and she receives. She receives everything she needs. The peace that passes all understanding, I release into her mind right now. She'll be able to think better, clearer. In the name of Jesus. Whatever the enemy's trying to do, we stop it in Jesus' name. We thank you, Lord, for your power working in and through these children, bringing Emily. She's laughing. She's laughing. She's laughing. That's the joy of the Lord. I didn't ask her to laugh. You look into the eyes of these little children. These are prayer warriors, but they're healing disseminators. The power of God goes through them. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for letting them. Back here. All right. About face. Thank you, Lord. Right back here. Do not start laughing. This is church. This is very serious. Do not smile. Do not laugh. Oh, you're doing a pretty good job. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Touch Janet right now. Right now. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Lord, for restoration. 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 Yeah, I think this same message, stirring up the joy, is for all of us today. Stir up the joy, Janet, every day. Every day. Oh, over here. All right. Got to have your hand up if you want us to stop. The train is moving. The train is moving. All right. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Lay our hands on this lady. It's up to the Lord Jesus Christ to do the rest. We do our part by believing and by laying our hands. He didn't say you had to say anything. And so as these children, I know this is touching their lives. They're going to remember this. They're going to remember this.
Yes, Jesus.
How God used you in church. That's why you want to come to church. To learn how to hear from God and then be obedient. Right? Okay. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Right over here, right behind the forget what your balloon is. Okay. You want to go put your shoes on. Okay. Well, maybe the anointing flows stronger with the shoes on. I'm not sure. Never been a problem for me, but joy of the Lord. Stir it up every day. Every day in Jesus' name. Release your peace, Lord Jesus. You are dear sister. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Never be the same after this day. God touched you. During kids' church, how about that? During kids' service, how can that happen? You mean God can be a fun God? Right here. Sweet lady. Oh my goodness. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name. We release God's power into our body. We release the peace of God into our body. I command your emotions to just settle down. Condemnation is just we want to find out what we can do to get to that place. We're just tapping into heaven right here. We're tapping into God's power. We've got to reach Him, right? And so by our obedience and by our believing, when we lay hands on people, He has to do his part. He has to do his part. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. She's a receiver. She's a receiver. Anybody else? If I sat down, I'd be in trouble. Hey, hey, hey. Okay, right here. Right here. This is precious. How are you doing? All right. You do better. It's going to be a better year, isn't it? It's going to be a great year. You keep speaking that, and that's what you'll have. That's right. That's right. God loves you so much. He wants everything for you. So what is it you need? Do you have pain in your body? You're not feeling great, okay? Well, we just thank you, Lord, that we release the power of God into his body yes. right now, from the top of his head to the soles yes. of his feet. I thank you, Lord. It's a done deal. God will do what he says.
Yes.
He said we have to be believers and we have to be obedient and lay hands on the sick, right? Or on those that have problems. And then he'll do his part. He's in the recovery business. We're in the transmitting business. We transmit the power. We carry the power, just like conduit in a water pipe or an electrical wire. We're carriers of that, right, kids? Yeah? Yeah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. You bet. You bet. Anybody over here? Over here. No embarrassing anybody. Yeah. He'll take some of it. He'll take some of it. You know, when you stir up the joy of the Lord, and when you release your faith, even when you're well, that's what will keep you well. We want to use our faith to stay well, not to just to have to get healed, get sick, get healed, get sick. No, we want to use our faith daily, just like you use a circular saw and a mechanic would use a wrench. Every day, they don't have to think about using that wrench to do what they got to do on that engine. So we need to use our faith, just like a mechanic would use a tool, right?
Yes.
And so what we're doing it by faith, right? Because on our own, we don't have the ability to do healing. It's we're contacting heaven right now by our faith. Faith is responding to what you know. And if God said to lay hands on the sick, you just simply obey him. And the power will stop flowing. It's just like you turning on the water faucet at home. Do you ever think that it might not come on? All right, don't answer that question. Okay. Moving down, we're almost done. Worship team's been up there a long time.
Yeah.
Anybody over here? Somebody's over here. All right. Mr. Murphy. Mr. Murphy. You got, how are you? Wonderful. So good to see you. Yeah, we can come. Yeah, he'll come out. Sure, sure. Now, he's a big guy, so it's going to take all of us. No. Well, they were looking like, will it work on somebody that big? I said, absolutely. Absolutely. Father, we thank you. Thank you for your amazing love and how you would even use little children to minister to this man. We thank you, Father.
Yes.
We give you the praise. We give you the glory. And Mr. Murphy gets the benefit of the power of God flowing into his body right now. Top of his head to the soles of his feet. We thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Did you feel that? I did. Yeah. And you don't have to feel anything, but when you do, it's pretty cool. Yeah. Yeah, he didn't say that, you know, they'd recover if they felt something. No, it's all about our hearts, receiving in our hearts. Over here, over here. Let's go around for Sister Catherine. All right, we're going to go around. She's way over there. Everybody good here? Good morning, dear. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. You're hungry? Yeah, me too. When I was talking about that porterhouse steak, I was beginning to get hungry. But we got to finish our work here. Catherine, God loves you so much, huh? And we just release God's power into your body. I command every ache, every pain, every bit of discomfort to leave your body right now. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Healing power of God through little kids and a big kid.
Amen.
Two big kids. Oh, okay. Well, that makes three then, because I'm a big kid. All right. Are we good? Is anybody else want to get in on this? You want to get in on this? You bet. You bet. You bet. You ready to receive? What's your name? Danica? I don't think I've ever met you. I'm Pastor John. It's a pleasure to meet you. Glory to God. Father, we thank you for Danica. You brought her here this morning, possibly for this purpose, to show her your love, to show her how real you are. And so we release your power into her body to restore whatever it is that's going on in her body. We thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I pray your peace. I just release your peace into her mind and her will and her emotions.
Yes.
I thank you, Lord, for the boldness that came up in her to be able to stand up here. So we thank you. I believe all your days ahead of you are going to be the best days of your life. No fear. I cast out all fear that would try to come on your mind. God hasn't given us a spirit of fear, but love, power, and a sound mind. I declare that you have a sound mind. Do you know Jesus? You do know Jesus. Praise God. You're my sister. I have a sister I didn't know. I just met her today. That's awesome. Yeah. Well, I hope you come back. Oh, you will? Next Sunday. This is your first time. What's your name, hon? Lauren, it's a pleasure to meet you. You got radical running around, too.
Amen.
You did. You get free in church. You do here at this church. I know that. Yeah. Yeah, there's no religion here. No, it's just the love of God. She needed it, definitely. Well, I'm so glad. I'm so glad that you came. Awesome. 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 Well, maybe we'll get to talk out after we're done here and we dismiss. Anybody else? Anybody else? We got Mr. Bass Player. Are you good, Pam? Tanya? You're good?
I'm good.
Okay. How about the drum player? Oh, thank you for remembering him. How about the drum player?
How about the drummer? Are you good?
Is he good or... Was that a victory?
That's, he's good.
Okay. Then he's good. Well, maybe we could have one more song to close.
Okay.
Well, just... Not one that will put him to sleep.
I don't know.
Well, do one we did before. Power of the Blood. That's a great one. Praise God. We love you guys. We're so thankful for you. Kids, you come up here with me. And we're going to finish out.
Let me do this again. Okay. Ready?
Ready.
Look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. He healed my body. He touched my mind. He saved me just in time. I walk on the praise's name. He stays just the same.
refreshments.